The problem is, you've been told and not told. You've been told, but none of you really understand. So I've decided I'll talk to you in a way that you will understand.
I started off with a bunch of young people whose lives were going to be shorter. By doing that, I thought we would get a new perspective on something that we barely look at, but we know all about, which is the fact that, you know, we do get older and we, at some point we're going to go. But that makes it sound rather gloomy. And so I was more interested in the questions, when you know that this is a backdrop to your life, what things become important, what things really matter.
You have to know who you are and what you are. It's the only way you'll lead decent lives.
It's such a hard thing to describe, but it's a love story between three best friends.
Ruth.
Kathy. And
Tommy.
And the way their lives unfold, their short lives unfold.
None of you will do anything except live the life that has already been set out for you.
You get completely wrapped up in the book, and then it starts revealing things that are more and more profound and more disturbing and more beautiful.
If you access the truths that I think are implicit in Ishiguro's narrative, they're not very easy truths.
It's a story about life, about everybody's life. We all die. We can't quite comprehend what that means. None of us can. Me sitting here right now at 24 knows that I'm going to die. I don't comprehend what that is. You can't run away from it.
The first thing you notice about the book, certainly from the point of view of adapting it, is that it has a three-act structure, and the first third is set in a school, and the second third is set in an area called the cottages, and then the third is set in essentially in hospitals. And that provided a good narrative structure to make the story operate.
Good morning, students.
Good morning, Miss Emily.
For me, the person who's going to do the screenplay is absolutely crucial. That's the first step. Because a novel tends to be many things, but somewhere there's a foundation, which I think is a single unified thing that lies at the bottom of the novel. And that's all I want, really, is for that thing to be conveyed in the film as well. And I felt Alex was absolutely right.
Exactly how much experience have you guys had with The Outside?
Quite a lot.
We haven't. It's honoured the book in a beautiful way, Alex Garland. His focus on what Ishiguro intended is to be lauded, because I can imagine it's quite rare that someone who takes on a piece of material, like, I'm sure that you want to make it your own in a certain way, and there's certain ego that comes in, but not with Alex.
Okay, well, don't feel scared, okay? There's nothing to it.
We aren't scared.
Every decision, every single creative decision in the film, we either referred back to the book or we went straight to Ishiguro, and he would see pictures of locations, and he'd see pictures of actors, and he would read changed lines in scripts, and he would then sometimes alter those lines. And we always had the luxury of going back to him and checking, is this right or not? And he would tell us.
We showed Ishiguro the film with like tremendous trepidation and anxiety, and stood outside, like, you know, waiting for the film to end, stood outside the screening room, and he seemed thrilled, and that was a massive relief for all of us.
Someone was saying that some Hailsham students in the past have managed to get into Feral.
If there was a boy and a girl and they were in love with each other and they could prove it, then they would be given a few years together before they began their donations. Who is it you go to? Who would we talk to if we wanted to apply?
Maybe none of us really understand what we've lived through, or feel we've had enough time.